I really enjoy my evening sessions, often just a couple of hours after work, but they can be the most productive hours of the day. Before I came to the main lake, I took a tour of Rook's Pond and the canal section. The Andrew Davis rods, Avon and Carp have identical bags, hence I arrived this evening with the wrong one. It was too late to change it now, but I was confident the Avon would cope.
At Rook's Pond, managed to squeeze in a couple of hours after work. Got down here, very, very little fish in the weed, which is what I was used to seeing last time I was here. But upon closer inspection, there's lots of fish feeding on the bottom, bubbles coming up, silt clouding. So I flicked out a piece of bread to catch the bubbles. First cast, and I've caught a common. Not big fish, but a lovely Rook's fish all the same. Really, really full of beans, this fish, so I'm going to hold him up quickly and show you, and then we'll get him back to the pond, see if we can catch another one. A lovely fish, lovely good start, really pleased with that. Sun's just starting to come out as well. It's been overcast all day, a bit drizzly on the way down here, but as soon as I started fishing the sun come out, and conditions look really good. It's still early in the afternoon, it's about 5 o'clock, 5:15, still fish moving out there now, pretty good sign. So I've got until dusk, until I can't see anymore because I've got no headlamp. So we'll see how we go on. Excellent start. Brilliant.
Things were quiet. The signs I'd been seeing had disappeared, so I made my way to the main lake for a look. At first it looked quiet, but after putting out a few pouchfuls of mixers, it was soon apparent that I had fish close by. After the fight, I returned to the camera to find it off, and thought I'd missed the whole thing. Luckily I managed to capture most of it. The fish scene was out of focus, unfortunately. Apologies for that.
Well, I moved on to the big lake. Started putting some dog biscuits out just by the pads, not far out, and got a few fish taken. Looked like small commons. Started fishing, got the camera rolling. For some reason, the camera stopped recording. So I quit gutted because it was an epic battle. And when I hooked this one, there we go. Quite a chunky old common. Took me ages to get it in. Really, really good battle. Really strong fish. I picked up the wrong rod, actually. I've got the Avon rod instead of the carp rod. So no wonder it gave me the runaround. But there we go. I've been a bit cagey, to be honest. I had some ducks come in and clear me out. One thing after another, but then the ducks cleared off, left me a bit of time, and we've got this one. So I'm really pleased with that. A couple of hours after work, can't complain. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to pop him back in the lake now and see if they're still out there taking. Absolutely brilliant. Well, that didn't take long. I put some more dog biscuits out on the same spot, and straight away the fish come up and started taking. So I cast out the hook bait just past the fish, drew it back in gently into where the fish was feeding, and took it without hesitation. And here's the result. Let's mirror this time. It's a lovely fish. Most chains are getting mirrored. There's not that many mirrors about. Lots and lots of commons, smaller commons. There's a few bigger fish. It's a nice clean mirror. Another good, really good scrap. Pulled my arm off this one. That's a lovely fish. I'm pleased with that. Yeah. So there he is. That's a cracker. A couple of swims along, the dog biscuits were blowing right into the bank. So I crept along, flipped one in real close, in amongst some feeding fish, and this one took. Just saw the mouth come up, tried a few times to take the dog biscuits, and unsuccessfully, and then all of a sudden I saw him go into its mouth, and the mouth closed, and I struck, and just stay deep, ponderously deep, round and round and round in circles, like all the good ones do. And it took ages to even see it, but as soon as it rolled, I saw the length, I saw the beautiful scales, I knew it was a good one. So obviously, knees turned to jelly. It didn't want to go in the net, rolled over the cord 3 or 4 times. But eventually she went in, and there she is. What a stunning carp that is. Got to be pleased with that. I'm going to put her back, and I'm going to see if I've got time for one more chance. What a fish that is.